Hey guys, Kevin Grant here. This is part two of your consciousness, or your I am is unlimited. Okay, so go ahead and like, get ready to share, subscribe, and click the bell icon so you know when I upload my video. And the reason I'm telling you to go ahead and like this video is because this is from the book Neville. This is from Neville Goddard's The Complete Reader, Volume 1. And I know you guys are going to get some very valuable, some priceless information. So go ahead and like, share, and subscribe so you know when I upload my next video. So we're just going to start. This is part two of your consciousness, or your I am is unlimited. When the widow asked, what she had in her house, there was recognition of substance. Her claim was a few drops of oil. A few drops will become a gusher if properly claimed. Your awareness magnifies all consciousness. To claim that I shall have oil, joy is to confess. What he's saying is, they're looking at oil as joy, okay? So to claim that I shall have oil, by all they mean joy, is to confess that I have empty measures. Let's go back again. To claim that I shall have oil or joy is to confess that I have empty measures. Such impressions of lack produce lack. God, your awareness, is no respecter of persons, purely impersonal. God, this awareness of all existence, receives impressions, qualities, and attributes defining consciousness, namely your impressions. So if you haven't watched part one, go ahead and listen to part one before you listen to this part two right here. So part one, go find your consciousness, or your I am is unlimited, part one. This is part two, okay? So purely impersonal, God, this awareness of all existence, receives impressions, qualities, and attributes defining consciousness, namely your impressions. Your every desire should be determined by need. Needs, whether seeming or real, will automatically be fulfilled when they are welcomed with sufficient intensity of purpose as defined desires. Knowing that your awareness is God, you should look upon each desire as the spoken word of God, telling you that which is. Cease ye from man, whose breath is in his nostrils, for wherein is he to be accounted of? We are ever that which is defined by our awareness. Never claim, I shall be that. Let all claims for now on be, I am that I am. Okay? Before we ask, we are answered. The solution of any problem associated with desire is obvious. Every problem automatically produces the desire of solution. Man is schooled in the behalf that his desires are things against which he must struggle. And Neville is saying we don't have to struggle. Let's back up. Man is schooled in the belief that his desires are things against which he must struggle. In his ignorance, he denies his Savior, who is constantly knocking at the door of consciousness to be let in. I am the door, your awareness of being, your consciousness, what you feel and know yourself to be. Would not your desire, if realized, save you from your problem? To let your Savior in is the easiest thing in the world. Things must be to be let in. You are conscious of a desire. The desire is something you are aware of now. Your desire, though invisible, must be affirmed by you to be something that is real. God calleth those things which be not, or not seen, as though they were. Let me read that again. God calleth those things which be not, are not seen, as though they were. Claiming I am the thing desired, I let the Savior in. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him, and he with me. Every desire is the Savior's knock at the door. This knock every man hears. Man opens the door when he claims, I am he. See to it that you let your Savior in. Let the thing desired press itself upon you until you are impressed with nowness of your Savior. Then you utter the cry of victory. It is finished. So, once again, your consciousness or your I am is the unlimited potential upon which impressions are made. Right? So, we have to realize that whatever we desire to have, be, or to do, we have to begin to affirm, claim, and feel that we are already being, doing, or having that right now. Because the statement from the Bible that says, believe and you shall receive, is saying basically you have to believe it, know it, affirm it, and then you will receive it, right? Because you already have it. Just grab the consciousness, the awareness of knowing that it already exists for you. Just become conscious that you are that. I am that. I am. So thanks for watching this video. I hope I was able to help you guys gain some valuable information. So don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and click the bell icon so you know when I upload my next video. And that was some information from Neville Goddard's book, The Complete Reader, Volume 1. So once again, thank you. I do one-on-one coaching. My information is below this video. So thank you for watching. Bye-bye.